The preliminaries are almost at an end here. We're just hearing the last few bars of the national anthem or on the vein. The teams are lined up in the middle. Referee John O'Reilly is ready to get proceedings underway. And special guest of the Fives, Brendan O'Shaughnessy, was on the field there with the Mayor of Galway, Donal Lyons, greeting the teams. Fives photographer Ian MacDonald is just getting the last couple of photographs of the two teams together before the final. And there's always one team in the final that's nearly impossible for the commentator to name. And Smakia Pitchup is the name of the boys in the Barcelona gear out there. No idea what that means. But they are featuring Owen Roach there at number 12. Fine player, Owen Roach. They've got Kevin Walsh, Rob Shire, Gavin Dillon, Jack Byrne, Alan Cowper, and Alan O'Boyle. Owen Roach, who formerly played at Salt 11, of course, and NUIG, and has played in quite a number of places, is the son of Mal Roach, who himself was a very famous footballer himself. The guys in the black gear, they're called Presto Land. And the interesting thing about these guys is these guys came through the backdoor GA style. They were beaten in the very first game yesterday morning, and here they are in the final at getting the second chance, which is excellent for them. They featured the three players in this lineup: number 3, Evan Preston Kelly; number 4, Dragos Babu; and Oscar Simbanda, who played some League of Ireland football with Salthill Devon when they were first division a couple of years ago. Oscar also played with Bellevue United. Evan Preston Kelly also played with Galway United. They've got Martin Rice in goals, and the final is on. And here we go, the 39th Carlsberg Fives final, and Owen Roach is the first one to push forward with the ball. Dragos Babu takes the throw into Rice. Rice will knock it long. Owen Roach, Alan Cowper, big number 5, has impressed quite a lot in this tournament. Roachy gets on it. Long ball through. Evan Preston Kelly nods the ball back to Rice. Long ball, but aimless. Wynn took it. Cowper to Roach. Gavin Dillon. Dragos Babu quickly into the tackle. Knocks it out for the corner. Ball is back with the keeper. Cowper, one more time. He will bring it forward. Owen Roach, wide left. Roach on the ball now. He will look to bring the player in before he gives it. And there's Cowper again, wide side. Roach's team in the Barcelona gear here. They're using the full confines of the ground, and that's what you've got to do when you're playing five-a-sides. You've got to keep the ball and move it around and try and get the other guys to come and get it and try and soak them in and strike when you get a chance, create overlaps, two-on-ones, etc. There's Cowper, big menacing figure, runs forward, very strong. Small Paul Smith closes him down, trying to get the ball, and does get the ball off him, but it is a throw into Cowper. And that's Paddy Walsh that took that throw to Owen Roach, who has been outstanding in this competition. And when our guest of honour, Brendan O'Shaughnessy, selects the player of the tournament later on, surely Owen Roach's name will be on that shortlist. But we can only guess, because that's the way it happens in the fives. The player of the tournament will not be announced until the after party down in the office bar in Salthill tonight, when the main trophies will be handed out, and the special guest Brendan O'Shaughnessy is keeping a close eye on this game, because it's very possible that the player of the tournament could come from this game. Should be noted, of course, that the guest this year, Brendan O'Shaughnessy, this tournament would not be here but for his ingenuity and vision. You know, 39 years ago or 38 years ago, we had the 39th Fives when he instigated this thing at this tournament. Preston Kelly now takes the ball off Dillon and drives forward. Very strong player, Cowper, with the tackle. You get the feeling. There's a free kick coming up now. Paul Smith is on it. Preston Kelly puts it down. He's going to line this up and he's going to really whack it. Oh, and he clips it off the bar. That's the first real chance of the game. So this is the second year in a row we braved the horrendous conditions last year. We're getting a respite this year to stream the finals of the National Fives on air, and we're thankful this year to Cormac Staunton of Staunton Media for providing the technology and the ingenuity to get this event online, on the web, live, wherever you are on the planet. This is co-sponsored by 1511 Communications, and that was Dragos Babu with the foul. He got the finger wagged at him here now by John O'Reilly. Would tell him not to do that again, and it was Paddy Walsh that felt that tackle. Owen Roach will line it up, and we could be getting the wrath of the rain gods coming at us again here. Owen Roach is going to flick it in. Paul Smith get the block. Knocks it back to his keeper. His keeper is Rob Shires. Back to... And as Dillon knocks it forward, Paddy Walsh just couldn't quite get his back in. And Oscar Simbanda now really in the game for the first time. And he gets the ball down, but Cooper knocks it out for the throw-in. Dragos Babu with the throw for Prestoland. Shire easily deals with that. He'll knock it out. He'll give it to Roach. Roach and Cooper available every single time the keeper has the ball, and that's what you want in this game. You've got to have a guy available to give the ball to easily in his line of sight, and there's Roach on the ball. Got a great goal here in this quarter final to win it when it went to overtime. That's very good by Paddy. He's been fouled. He's a play on here. That was good. That was good use of the advantage there by referee Riley. That was excellent. Cowper. The one thing you notice about both of these sides is the level of fitness. This is a lung buster of a competition. Especially you have to play four games on the Sunday to win it. And here's Cowper now. He's going to go forward. He shows very, very quick feet for a big man. This guy is deceptively quick over the ground. Gavin Dillon, number 11, with the throw. Actually, it's corner. Paddy Walsh. Owen Roach. And Evan Preston Kelly concedes the corner. Roach has been in everything in this tournament, and he walks away now, but he will turn and come back, and hopefully to get on this one again. Presto gets it away again. Oscar, and Oscar is away. Oscar Simbanda, clean pair of heels, and tries to knock it into Smith. That is surely a free kick. That could be the first yellow card. John O'Reilly's shown some leniency there. It was kind of a needless tackle by Smith there. And Paddy Walsh has shown himself to be a very nippy player at both ends of the pitch. He got back very smartly then, and we've arrived at halftime. And it's stalemate here in the final of the 39th National Fives. Streaming live on the internet, brought to you by Staunton Media and co-sponsored by 1511 Communications for Salthill Devon. As the rain is starting to come down, neither team are looking to stand around and chat at halftime. They're going to get on with it. The spectators will be very glad of that. Paul Smith will tip it off to Oscar Simbanda. Oscar will drive forward. Strong player, very nippy, Simbanda. was certainly fouled two or three times by Owen Roach there. Eventually gets the free. Great attitude, Simbanda. Just gets on with the game. No complaining or looking for a free. He knows the referee's in charge. He'll get it if he deserves it. Owen Roach will try one more time to bring his team into the game to Cowper. It's with Shire to Cowper. He'll give it back to Shire again. They will play keep ball. They will try and drag Presto Land into coming forward, but they're not having any of it. They're keeping two men back. They've kept Evan Preston Kelly and Brabu back there most of the time. Roachie again will have it. Covered every inch of this ground over the last 2 days. Gavin Dillon, also a very strong, very quick player. He drives forward, and that is a cracking shot, but just over the bar. Referee Riley signals it was the keeper got a touch on that. So Rob Shire, Rob Shire is at the other end. That was Martin Rice who got a touch on that and put it over the bar. It must be the winter rain in the middle of the summer here that's getting us a brain freeze up here as we try to figure out what's happened. The rain is starting to come down again as the ball is not forward. Babu, very strong defender, good player, well capable of playing at a good level of football. And it's back to Shire from Roach. That's a free kick, surely. That was Alan O'Boyle fouled. He trots forward on Roach. He won't be rushed into it. Very composed player, Roach. Shire to Roach. Johnny O'Brien, number 6, I see, has come into the game for Presto Land. And I'm trying to see, it's Oscar Simbanda, who has departed the pitch. So we have rolling subs here, so guys can sneak off and you know, and see them. So Johnny O'Brien, another very experienced local player here, long career in junior football, always keeps himself in good condition. And he will be certainly pretty lively here for the last 4 or 5 minutes that he's in this game before we go to overtime, if indeed that's what happens. There's Roach now, a very neat ball into O'Boyle, back into Roach. Babu takes it. A chance here now for... well saved. And the ball is hoofed out again by Presto. Cowper. And the ball has gone harmlessly wide and will start again with Rob Shire in the smack ya pitch up goal. Back to Shire. And that is a very ugly looking tackle. O'Brien was coming in very, very fast there. Owen Roach has a word. That looked very, very dangerous. Very, very dangerous. I think it's going to be a yellow card for Johnny O'Brien here. I don't think he came in with anything else, but that was a very dangerous tackle. He's really got to be a lot more careful. Gavin Shire quite lucky there. Kick out by Shire following that free kick. He looks as if he's okay to continue. Probably a little unhappy with that tackle, still feeling it from Jerry O'Brien, but this game has overtime written all over it, but at least when it gets, that's when some one or other of the teams have got to come out and play. Both teams here have been quite defensive minded. With Presto Land keeping two people back most of the time. There's somebody who's down injured. That's Gavin Dillon. That's down injured. Did he get a clip or has he pulled something? He doesn't look... He looks quite distressed. Now, he would be a big loss if he has to go off. But I expect that that Paddy Walsh could come back into the game, because he was replaced by Alan O'Boyle quite a while ago, just after half time. So it's the game is in a little bit of a hiatus here at the moment while we figure out what. Dylan looks okay. Less than 100% perhaps, but he's happy enough to go on. And it goes straight to him. He's going forward. He's not moving as smoothly as he was early on, but he'll, you know, there isn't much left. He'll give it a chance. He can relax later on, relax tomorrow. Big man Cowper on the ball. Owen Roach, excellent play. And Dylan, very good play. If he can knock that ball in, oh, that would have deserved a goal. That was a really, really good play. Dylan was lucky enough there, I suppose, in one way, that Evan Preston Kelly overcommitted himself in the tackle. He turned him, he got in there, and that was a really, really good shot, but just wide. Gavin Rob Shire with the ball back to Cowper. These boys have started the ball from the back almost the same way every single time. Paul Smith puts him under pressure there and he concedes the throw. One or other of these teams is going to have to make a super effort here in the next minute or two and maybe throw caution to the wind if they're going to win it. At the moment, it looks as though both sides are a bit scared to lose, so neither of them are going to win it. Dragos Babu shields the ball out over the line for a throw-in. Presto lands keeper. Rice has the ball. Martin Rice knocks the ball. Terry O'Brien, and there it is. That's the final whistle, and we are going to get overtime. And overtime seems to have been the order of the weekend in this tournament, because in virtually every game in the last 16 this morning went to overtime. And that means that's why our final is a little bit late today. But here we are, we're in overtime. The goalkeepers are coming out. The sun is shining, thank the Lord, for the first time in quite a while. So we've sort of escaped a little bit there. But it's really going to need somebody to make a big effort here now. Who is going to be the braver team? And it's the brave team that will go and win this tournament. It's a chance for one of the players out here to put his stamp on everything. After all the games, after 2 days, can Presto Land be a team that lost in the first round and end up winning the tournament? Or can it be Owen Roach's team? Smack Your Pitch Up is the name of the team. We'll have to have a word about that later on. And the overtime is on. Smack Your Pitch Up kept Shire on the pitch and took Alan O'Boyle off, and the Presto Land did remove their goalkeeper. So even though Rob Shire is still on the pitch, he can no longer handle the ball. So Evan Preston Kelly, and there's a corner. He tries a long shot. It goes off Gavin Dillon. It's out for a corner to Presto Land, and Jerry O'Brien will take it. Back to Presto. It's about all you can do with a corner when it's down to 4-on-4. This is going to be, well done by Owen Roach. They're a good block, really good shot by Evan Preston Kelly. And it'll be back to him again. Now somebody's got to go and close him down. So this is the sort of game of cat and mouse. And really, we want something a little bit more subtle than that if you're going to win the final of the National Fives. And could Owen Roach, who was on the ball now, could it be him? Big man, great feet. Loses it there. This is trouble now. Jerry O'Brien. The flag is up. We couldn't quite see it from where I was standing here. But the flag was up. I thought the final was over. Jerry O'Brien will hope that he gets another chance like that. Owen Roach gets out of jail. Now, Gavin Dillon. Gavin Dillon with the ball to Roach, to Shire. Shire will look for it. They've Jerry O'Brien is a willing runner here. Cowper, big man. So, oh, there is a big mistake. Oh, they gave it away and they got it back. This could be, here's Dylan. Oh, it's a smack to desperation, that shot. He should really have held on to that ball. Oh, there's two tired teams out here now. The mistakes are coming thick and fast. Presto gave the ball away. That's Evan Preston Kelly. He's out for a throw. Owen Roach steadies everything down. This is what he's done in every single game. He'll slow it to a walk, and then suddenly they'll explode into action. So is it Cowper that's going to make his way for the ball, or will he throw it back to Shire? And he's going to force Presto Land to come looking for the ball. Jerry O'Brien was a willing runner, but he can't cover every eventuality, and now they go forward. Gavin Dillon down the right-hand side gets past Babu, who concedes the corner. And it's a corner to smack you. Pitch up in the corner. Gavin Dillon with the ball, and he's going to take this corner. Jerry O'Brien is standing 3 or 4 yards away. Roach didn't quite get his hands up. Babu knocked it out for the throw-in. So it's a throw-in to smack your pitch up. Dylan has the ball in his hands. I think we're going down to three aside. Paul Smith and Rob Shire have exited the fray. So now it's three aside. Now surely we're going to see a winner here. Surely. So Alan Cowper has the ball in his hands. He will take the throw. So what? Smack your pitch up. They've changed their mind. They've left Rob Shire on. Maybe he's a bit fresher than Gavin Dillon, who's gone off. Now, Owen Roach has the ball. Now, there's plenty of room here. But what does he do? He did this earlier on today against West United, I think in the last 16, or it could have been the quarterfinal. He drew players out, he went forward, and he put a left-footed shot in the top of the net. So can he do it today? This is a chance for Cowper to win the fives. This must be it, surely. And it's a cracking goal. Evan Preston Kelly could do nothing about it. And the winners of the 39th Carlsberg National Fives are a team called Smack Ya Pitchup. And they beat Presto Land in the final, driven forward by Owen Roach. And Alan Cowper was the man, the big number five, who got on the ball and smacked it into the corner of the net. That was a really, really good goal, and a goal worthy of winning the National Fives. So thanks very much to everybody, and hopefully those people out there who have been watching our game today. You know, we'd like to thank you all for tuning in. And it's, you know, we'll be hoping to come back and be all back here a year later. We'll be having the 40th Fives next year. And again, just to remind you once again that the this broadcast has been brought to you compliments of Staunton Media and 1511 Communications. Thanks very much indeed.